Morning, everybody. Nick here with Antique Bottle Glasses. I just got a huge order from Brandon from Adventure Archaeology, so we're gonna unwrap them and see what he sent. Let's get to it. All right. I didn't hear any clinking noises, so I think everything made it in one piece. Let's see what we got here. We got a Coca Lula here, a really nice clear one. It's got some stuff in the inside from the creek, but that was a real fresh one because it's got no river rash or creek rash on there. All right, let's see. Okay, that's an older Pioneer. Circle slug there. I believe this is the older one. I always love the mystery of seeing what he's sending. Although I see him on his video, so it's not too much of a mystery, but still, I don't know exactly what's coming. This one's still wet. All right, he's got some cracks on the top there. So that's where I'll start the cut, right there. Although the crack is going up, so it probably won't travel down. That's an old Pioneer. You hear any wind noises, so I got this giant fan on behind me. This is an old attic fan from the 50s. This is the old style air conditioner right here. This is the only way to keep the mosquitoes off me while I work. Boy, you must have run into a pocket of Pioneers. Another Pioneer. That's one I haven't seen too many with the property of up there. Super clear. That's some nice glass right there. Hope everyone's out there handling the heat okay. This is pretty crazy here in Florida. It's getting pretty hot. This one's clinking. That might mean something's broken in there, or it could just be stuff. Oh, we got a damaged one here. Hopefully it's not a good one. All right, well, it's a Pioneer. Was a Pioneer. It happens sometimes. Very rarely, but it does happen. Got here. Wow, it's just a Pioneer wrapped a Pioneer. Pioneer. He's never sent this many Pioneers. He must have just run into a seam of them. All right, this one looks a little different. All right, it's got neck damage there. So this is one that's going to be a little bit of a challenge because if I cut above here, it really doesn't leave a lot of room to make the lip. I'm gonna cut it off right there and see how it looks. Might shave a little bit of that C off there, but I'm gonna try it tall first. If I have to, I'll cut it down, leaving the New Orleans on there. That is a Consumer's Seltzer and Mineral Water Manufacturing Company Limited, New Orleans. That's a cool one. It's got some Alabama in there. Let's see what this says. Keaveney, K-E-A-V, Keaveney, and Buckley. It says, wow, it's hard to read what that says. Bottling house, city bottling house. And it's got 69 to 71 Liberty Street. Wow, that is a cool bottle there. That's a cool bottle, man. smash on the top there. So I should be able to cut this one just above here. Save most of that embossing. I'm gonna have to, because that crack looks like it goes down. Yeah, I might have to cut a little bit of the embossing off on that one. Rhyola. Well, that's got a really nice heavy-duty embossing on there. That's gonna make a really nice double shot glass. I've checked, I call them double shot glasses because they hold about a double. All right, it's one of those Sinalcos, and these things are a challenge to cut, I'll tell you, because when you put them inside the, over here, I'll give you a little example. If you were just to lay this up like this, it's going to cut that thing at an angle. So you've got to get it situated so it's straight, and then you got to wedge it in there with a piece of wood down this end so it doesn't budge. And even then, it's not right this way. So you gotta kick it up a little bit and then wedge it straight. And even then it still won't cut it completely straight. So I have to work on getting it straight after I cut it. Those are definitely a challenge, but they make really interesting glasses. Pioneer. Another really clear Pioneer. Those don't have to be tumbled at all. This is the Pioneer order, another clear, really clear Pioneer. All right, cool, another try me. These make such cool double shot glasses because of this wide band right here gives them a really nice lip. I cut it just above that and it makes a nice, real wide double lip. So another Rhyola, that's the last one, I believe. I still have people contacting me weekly, trying to give them information on how to do this. So I do tell people how to cut them and how I clean them. I don't tumble them, but I do use like a 500 grit wet sandpaper on the inside and the outside, and that removes pretty much everything. It doesn't hurt the embossing, doesn't scratch the bottle at all, but it does remove like rust stains and other crap that's on there. But nothing will get rid of the haze out of the bottle besides tumbling. But they're always wanting to find out how I'm shaping the lips, and it's just a trade secret. It's not easy, I'll tell you that much. It's a lot of elbow grease and very difficult. A lot of people want to use like belt sanders and stuff like that. I tried that in the beginning, and belt sanders just get too hot and they'll crack the glass. Same with Dremels. They get too hot and will crack the glass. And also it's very hard to get a straight line with Dremels. So anyway, there we go. That's the order right there. They go from this nasty to nice and clean and with a nice beveled lip on them. These two are for an artist. I didn't do a really good lips on him because he just wants them for his watercolor brushes. I got a few over here that I've been sort of saving for my inventory. A nice twitchel there. Some of these are difficult because, like, say this one right here, I cut it and there's a giant bubble in there. I can sometimes knock that bubble out and then file it, so I'll probably be doing that on that one. A nice twitchel here. This is a P. de Ross. really nice embossing on these things. Super early Philadelphia squats. It's a nice one. Johnson & Co. Philadelphia mineral water. Again, with this one of these giant bubbles in there. I think I can fix that one. And I got this one is another, is an E. Duffy, but it's got a big scar on there, so I'll probably let that one. But look at that. That patina on there is just amazing. So I probably won't be sanding that off or attempting to remove it just because it's really beautiful. Let's see what else we got here. This one's a really hazy one. It's an F. McKinney, the big F on there. This is a Geo Flanagan, and some other ones in there. And then my bottle collection going all the way to back there, up there. I've got some crates in the back too, including all these cases of bottles in here. Yeah, this goes on and on and on. All my Arrowhead digging shovels from the past. These were ponies that were like down to here, probably double the size. And as you sharpen them and resharpen them in the sand, it takes off metal. You end up with a punish shovel looks like that. I save them because it's hard to find these ones anymore. The newer ones are just really heavy and they're made from crap metal. Anyway, so there we go. I'll see you next time.